Hey everybody, Michael here, Starkiller77. It's been quite a while since our last video, almost a year, and I just wanted to do a follow-up on what's been going on the last year. A lot of you people that might not know, we've been building from the ground up a really, really cool pizza restaurant called the Dark Side Brick Oven Pizza Company that's going to be 70s, 80s nostalgia. That's going to be filled with prop replicas from Jaws, from E.T., from Star Wars to Battlestar Galactica, just all of the really cool movies that touched all of us back when we were younger. But just wanted to do a follow-up and let you guys know what's kind of going on right now and show you a little bit of the collection that we've added in the last year. It's been a rough year. This month it's going to be almost 1 year since I lost my beautiful mom, and it's been tough, but thanks to the love of my wife and my family, I've been getting through it and just struggling through it, and I know that she's a force above watching me, and I hope that I'm making her proud on everything that we're doing. It's really exciting, and most importantly, what we're doing is going to be for you guys to enjoy, and that's the most exciting part of this whole thing for me. Yeah, so these have been creeping the wife out for quite some time. These obviously are gonna be going to Dark Side. But here we have the Mighty Doc Brown and his original vintage 80s Futaba remote that controls the DeLorean. Howard S. did the sculpt on the head, and it's absolutely fantastic. And of course we had the suit tailored. We still have to do his tool pack and a couple other little deals to finalize his display. We've already shipped Marty up to Dark Side, which we're gonna show you a picture here shortly. Marty turned out fantastic. So the DeLorean, and we're just missing Doc, and he's almost ready to ship out. Next to Doc, we have, if you vintage gurus are gonna know, this is Teen Wolf, played by Michael J. Fox. Another Howard sculpt, fantastic. This one here, it just came out of the box done. I mean, I didn't have to really tweak with this one here, but the sculpt, the headphones, everything about this thing is just dynamic. Just love it. I just added the basketball to it. His shoes actually need to be going on Marty McFly, and we're putting Adidas on here because we're gonna try to make it 100% accurate. Those shoes are actually going on Marty, so we just gotta flip those. But it's been crazy the amount of life-size sculpts we've been doing for Dark Side. But I'm so particular because we want, when it's a monster or it's a droid robot, you know, it's not quite as hard to replicate. But when it's a human form, like Doc, it's just, you know, I don't want people to walk in and be like, eh. I mean, it's okay, but I want people to be like, oh, I thought it was him. And I think with this guy, we're absolutely getting that look. So, moving on. Okay, so here's a couple more busts. This one right here is next in the run to get the body. And a friend of mine, Michael, he lives in California, is an incredible artist when it comes to taking a head sculpt, taking a mannequin and outfits made by various, you know, seamstresses and creating these unbelievable lifelike figures. A lot of you guys have seen in my past videos, I did it was actually my very first one. It was a God Aiken head of Luke Skywalker, Mark Hamill. And I got a mannequin for it, and I just could not, Denise helped me, you know, we just could not get the poses right where it still looked like a mannequin. And that's what I was talking about when it comes to the realistic. I don't want it to look like a pretty good looking mannequin. I want it to be like, oh, I thought that was Mark Hamill or Luke Skywalker. I could never get that effect. Well, that was until I met this guy, Mike. Mike, you nailed it. It's en route to me right now. I cannot wait to receive it. But he completely took my best friend Luke and took it completely down to the guts. Got a brand new mannequin for it, cut it down, refiberglassed it, put in this this really cool metal manufactured piece that him and a buddy of his did, where his head can be completely articulated. So it's fantastic. I'm going to show you guys a couple pictures right now. What do you guys think about this? It's pretty nice. So can't wait to get that. And of course, the Bespin Luke is going to be displayed with Master Yoda and Swamp R2, which we're getting ready to see here shortly. Right here is, like we just talked about, is Obi-Wan. This is another Howard sculpt. The guy is very, very talented. This doesn't count. This is to my Regal robot. My house is just so cluttered full of stuff right now because you know how we are about displays. We're going to have that beautiful, perfect display, but right now everything's just so packed because we're trying to get all this stuff ready for the restaurant, and we're now starting to get the bottleneck cleared out of here, so it's looking really good. This is a God Aiken piece right here. You know, this is from Commando. Did I say Commando? I'm so sorry. This right here is actually Predator. What am I talking about? And I also have the actual Predator from the original being made right now. It's going to be a bust-up Predator, and it's fantastic. And my plan is to display them with, you know, a jungly background. So that ought to be pretty cool. Again, these are just temporary displayed. This right here is from a company called, this is Elite Creature Collectibles. And if you haven't heard of these guys, unbelievable work. The gentleman that did this one, and he just finished up E.T. I've got that one coming. The E.T. is fantastic. It's got the real heartbeat. You guys might have seen it at the San Diego Comic-Con. It was really, really cool. But this is one of the aliens from Close Encounters to the Heart film. Love that piece right there. So no, I'm not pretending to be Jason Voorhees. This is actually a found part machete from World War I, World War II that Quint used to cut the rope to release the barrel, as well as to stab at Jaws Bruce as he was being absorbed and eaten up alive. This is an incredible piece, heavy. So this is a French Army machete that was used very heavy. It's got a lot of weight to it. And I just had my friend Ariel, a lot of you guys might know this guy, he does really good work with the plaques. So this is gonna be displayed with the machete, kind of give you guys an idea of, you know, the history of this part. It's really popular nowadays, people finding found parts or what's, you know, like for Star Wars, what's involved in putting a lightsaber together. How do they make that lightsaber, or Luke's binoculars and putting that stuff together? It's really, really, it's a crazy, sick community of people. They are just so involved in this stuff, but I find it very interesting, really, really cool. This right here is also one of the life jackets, not from the actual movie, but it is a vintage that they used in the, you know, that style of life jacket, that brand of life jacket used in Jaws, and that's going to be the display on that one. This one's actually for a friend of mine, and we're doing one that's going to be duplicated, that's going to be going in Darkseid. Who's not a Jaws fan, right? So this right here is, whenever I build these, I build them because I'm trying to match the look inside the house, and so I can get away with that without the wife complaining too much. This right here, this statue, is actually a pretty expensive statue. So it's over, a little over $3,000. I don't normally talk about money, but I was pretty surprised. But this thing did sell out. It was fantastic. Actually, one of my favorite pieces. And the details, I added some blood spills to it here where they were throwing the dead fish over to bring up Bruce. If you can see, I added a lot of accurate blood to him in the gills and some stab things when they were shooting at him and stuff. And then, but look at the details inside. It's just absolutely amazing. Actually, they kept shooting the harpoon darts into him, so I put some little ropes in there, just kind of add a little something to it. And ironically, what was really, really cool about this, about a year ago, I had ordered it actually has a piece of the actual orca, and it's a production used piece of the orca. And so I thought I'd make a really, really nice display, you know, with this ship. Just love this piece. It's awesome. So this is a piece that I acquired from a dear friend of mine, actually a couple of them, one being Jason Eaton. This is a fun project that Tom Spina and his friends and family over at Regal Robot did. This was a fun piece designed to be for, it was a collective of different artists that would take the studio scale turret cannon that was in Star Wars A New Hope. These were actually cast off the originals, which is really, really cool. And they would do all kinds of different, you know, ideas. Some of them made, I think it was a lighthouse. It was just, there's about 10 different ones. Well, Tom decided to put the trash monster in this one, and I thought it was just absolutely badass. I had to have it. And he was generous enough to work it out where I can have this in the Starkiller collection, and I'm really, really happy with it. It's really cool, all the snot stuff coming off of it. Unfortunately, it did show up with a couple of breaks, and I just used some hot glue gun. You can't even tell because it kind of blended in. And behind me, real popular, is a lot of the concept maquettes that are coming out through Regal Robot. We've got some of these that I've had since our last video. The Max Rebo. This one is absolutely a newer one. We got Riyis here, the Tauntauns. I do have Weequay in another room, and a couple that we do have on order. And this, you guys have seen before. This is my favorite, the Tauntaun maquette. And we actually took Tom's, custom painted it, and threw this guy on it. Mike Salzo helped me out with that. We were going to still continue to put a little bit of cloth on it, but it looks very accurate to the original one that you see sitting on George Lucas's desk. Really, really cool. But yeah, these are really, really neat pieces. It's not that I don't have enough items in my collection, because we all know that it's like, it's overwhelming. But a Grail piece that I've always wanted, I was able to get about 6 months ago from my friend Ariel, who actually does the plaques. And this is going to be the EFX Ralph McQuarrie Signature Edition Darth Vader concept helmet. I still got to get the case built for it. Through the help of my friend Lee, we're going to have this thing displayed simply like this, and we're working on the lighting. Whether or not we're going to be drilling holes through this, not sure yet, but the colors, it's hard to see through the camera, but it's got beautiful purples and blues and blacks. It's just, it's incredible piece. I'm actually really shocked that EFX hasn't done more of the McQuarrie collection. Hopefully with the changes that have taken place with the unfortunate loss of Brian, maybe things will get back on track and they can get back into the, I would love to see the McQuarrie thing. I think that would, there's no doubt it would sell. And excuse behind me, this would be my lovely wife Denise's collection. She, you can find her on YouTube on the Barbie Fan Gallery. Is that right? Barbie Fan Gallery? Barbie Fan Gallery. Anyways, so, yeah, she's got her own little gallery of fun collectibles. It makes things very interesting. It's like, I buy something, then she's got to get something. I get something, then she's got to get something. Something's going on there. We need a bigger house is what it is. Now,
you're like chain smokers, but with collectibles.
Oh man, that's something. And also I want to show you guys, this is a really cool piece from my friend Marcel. Cool story behind this. All you guys know of our channel that me and Gabe put on, it's called Collection Wars. So he put a limited edition, did the Darth Vader McQuarrie. I remember one evening after the show, me, Marcel, Lee, and Gabe were talking about this, and it became a reality. And he used Lee's actual McQuarrie helmet as reference, and this is what came from it. And Marcel did the signature on it, and it's funny, I'm seeing a lot of people come up with the same picture frame, but that's fine. It's a beautiful, beautiful look. So this right here is what you see when you're sitting at the Thanksgiving table. Temporarily, obviously, like everything. That's what I tell the wife. It's temporary, babe. It's been here for almost a year. This is built and designed by Dan and his team. Fantastic, beautiful Wampa statue. I would say this thing, looking at the scale, looking, you know, at my big head right by him, he's going to be a quarter scale Wampa. Behind this thing, when I say behind it, this is the inspiration to my life-size Wampa. So Richard Riley, who did my life-size, took this pose. So we took the pose of this and actually, out of respect, reached out to Dan and said, hey man, we're gonna take the Wampa stance that you have and we're gonna make it life-size. He was thrilled to death. And obviously, the stance is very menacing. The only thing that we added to it was, because with Dan's pieces on this one, you could get him dragging Tauntaun. And Richard has actually done a Tauntaun before, so I was like, hey, what do you think about him dragging a Tauntaun? He goes, I got something better, what about Luke? And I was like, oh, damn. So, as you guys have seen, it's happening, we did that. So, but Richard took just pictures of this and created the life-size, almost 9 feet tall Wampa, but the quarter scale, Dan had this is the artist proof, and I had to have it, and he was wholesome enough to say, you know what, Michael, no problem. I'd love for you to have it in your collection, and here it is. And this is a piece that I'm going to be keeping here at the house. So, great job, Dan. Great job, Dan and team. I did a wonderful job. One of the closest movies of all time to my heart is absolutely the movie E.T. DB Studios actually did this one. His finger lights up. This one is absolutely going to Dark Side. And I just got this vintage robe. There was just something about E.T. with no clothes on, but this robe is almost on point to what he had in the movie. And obviously, we all remember in the vintage days, the Speak and Spell from Texas Instruments. This right here, I just picked up and it works too. Still working on his pot of flowers that he revitalizes. And it's really cool. We've got some vintage Coors beer cans coming that we're gonna have around him. So this is when he was intoxicated and, you know, him and E.T. were feeling, him and Elliot were feeling each other. And it's just an iconic part of the movie that I won't ever forget. And is actually probably one of the funniest parts of the whole movie. But yeah, great job, DB Studios. Home, E.T. phone home, badass. Here we have a model that my good friend Mike Salzo put together. It's a small model, but it was hell when we got the kit. There was just a lot of prep in getting this thing finalized, but we got the little heartbeat in this guy. He's about an inch tall, and we're gonna do a really cool scenery with this ship and have it on display with E.T. You guys will get to see this thing on display soon, the Blockade Runner. This thing is about a little over 4 feet tall, lights up. It's here in the model shop right now, but getting ready to transport over into the studio gallery. So here we have Arnold the Terminator and T2. This is for the second edition movie that was done. This one has a really cool story behind it. There's a lot of artists that were involved. I picked this up from my buddy Manning at Portomac Studios. And getting this thing, I don't know if you guys remember Planet Hollywood, but Planet Hollywood, and there was, of course, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Sylvester Stallone, and some other private investors had these iconic restaurants with themed movie props throughout and they're no longer in business. Well, Stan Winston Studios went in production and made, I think there was 14 of these that were made. And these are off the same sculpts of the 14. So I'm not sure which one or where this one came from, but it's spot on to the others. I did add a little bit of blood to it, some modern day beat up. But if you look at the skin tones and just if you could see, and his eye does light up, and this one is going to the Dark Side actually next week. It's going to be beautifully displayed. I'm looking forward to it. Here is from the original Terminator, called the Trucker, and it's an appropriate name because what we're going to do is we're going to take some hands and we're going to get a steering wheel, and it's going to be the scene when he's inside the semi truck driving, and his eyes does light up. So Suckface Studios did this. He did a great job on it, and we still have a little bit of work to do. But what I love about it is it's when you see it, it's like, oh, it's fake. It doesn't really look like him, but it looks exactly like what you see in the movie, which is iconic. And that's what really made me want to get this thing. So again, we still have to do a few more little things to it to have him driving. But when he's got his hands on the steering wheel and stuff, he's going to be legit. So our last video, which was, as you guys might know, almost a year ago, we had talked about the future studio scale room that we were going to be adding to the gallery. This is going to be approximately a little over 1,000 square foot. It's not too crazy big, but it's bigger than average room. And it's going to be specific for just the studio models. And what's really, really cool is finally my Star Destroyer is 8.5 feet long. The medical frigate, it's almost 9 feet in length. These are going to finally have a home, and they're going to be displayed properly the way these artists deserve their models to be showcased. And I'm going to be really excited on our next video to show you the completion of this room and displayed of all of the studio scale models. It's going to be fantastic. But a real quick sneak peek tour. Over here, you're going to see some specific pedestals that are going to be displayed for each specific model that we have. We got some really, really cool lighting that we're going to be doing down here. The medical frigate's going to be right here, along with the Calamari ship that Jason Eaton did, which was a background ship, as well as the shuttle transport. This is like the focus of the room. We've got the 4.5 foot Y-wing that'll be in the center. We've got the Star Destroyer over there, and we're going to have some really, really cool photographs of all of the ILMers from the 70s and early 80s, which is going to be really, really cool. Behind you, we have like where the 4.5 foot AT-AT's going to be. It's going to be displayed. And a lot of these are going to be diorama pieces. I love dioramas, as you guys might already know. So it's going to be cool seeing each individual model showcased the way they need to be. But stay tuned. The electrical's done. They just finished doing all the foam insulation. So probably in about another 3 weeks, all the sheetrock work will be done, and then we're going to be moving on to the flooring, and then the AC will be in, and it's going to be exciting to just start bringing in all the models. So I'm excited, looking forward to showing you guys, and that will probably be on the next video that we do. So here is the second R2 I have in the collection. This one was built by a friend of mine named Eric, a great guy, great artist. Who created the swamp version R2. He did everything that I asked. It lights up, it's beautiful. You guys will get to see this thing on display with the Luke Bespin that we were talking about, as well as Yoda. It's gonna be a fantastic diorama, and I cannot wait to have them all three displayed together, because now that I think about it, there's nowhere that you could go in the world and see something quite like this, which is, you know, an honor for me to be able to show you guys, the fans that love this stuff as much as I do. I mean, it's got to be showcased, it's got to be seen, and we're making that happen. Okay. So here we have, I believe we showed this in a previous video. I know we've showed it on Instagram, but this my buddy Philip did. It's a 6-scale scratch built over 1,100 individual pieces out of styrene snowspeeder. It is my favorite all-time ship in the Star Wars universe. I love the Snowspeeder. There's a bunch of them that I do like. This one I just received. This is the Jazz Ink Snowspeeder. It's badass. It lights up. It's a really, really cool piece. Me personally, I like this one. This one here looks a little bit more. I was fortunate enough, obviously, to have this guy scratch build this for me, but this just looks like right out of the film. And it's a lot more accurate to the actual film used piece, where the Jazz Ink one looks like it was replicated right out of a Black Series Snowspeeder. So if you like the toy version, this is a 6-scale version blown up, and the guys over there at Jazz Ink did a fantastic job. I mean, it's really cool. There's nobody else out there that's building big ass vehicles, and Houston, the team over there, are killing it. Good job. Here I got this one just got in. We've got Luke Skywalker, and also I've got the new custom Dak. Joel Hossie did that for me. So I got both of the 6-scale figures. And this random piece sitting here is an RS Prop Masters Biker Scout that, thanks to my friend Sean, was able to get for me the whole outfit. So we're gonna have the Biker Scout sitting on a life-size speeder bike, which I'll show you guys here shortly. I'm on display at the Darkside Brick Oven Pizza Company. And now that we are shining on this little area right here, I wanna go ahead and tell you guys. So my newest commission, anybody recognize this? I know it's not Star Wars, but here is my original vintage Maximilian from Black Hole. This one just came out in really, really great detail. Really cool. Anyway, a buddy of mine, Ryan, does a lot of prop replicas, great work. Me and him were talking about it, because before I've talked about having one of these life sizes. It's never been done. There's been a few of them that have if you look online and you type in life size Maximilian, nothing pops up. I've seen that. I know that one guy tried to do one out of foam and it looked pretty good, but they just created the files. And my friend Michael McMaster, a lot of you guys might know Michael. He is known in the Robot R2 Builders Club universe. He's done a lot of stuff. He worked on Mandalorian. He did the R5 and the Probe Droid life size. Anyways, he's commissioning me a life-size Maximilian, and I cannot wait to show you guys. And everybody keeps saying, hey, is that gonna go to Dark Side, or what are you gonna do with that one? And it's gonna stay in my private collection. It's just something about him. Now, when it comes to droids, I mean, if you're asking specific Star Wars, what's my favorite droid, that's one thing, but droids period, I would have to say it's Maximilian. Can you imagine a 7.5-foot life-size? Stay tuned, you're gonna see one. So here we have the life-size Yoda. This one has had a lot of upgrades from the original guy, Phil, over in the UK that did it. He does great work. And when we got it, we definitely did a lot more weathering on the cloak, and I sculpted the feet on him. I wanted him to be comfortable sitting, and yeah, it's my first sculpt ever. It turned out pretty good. I was pretty proud of it. David Boudreaux, a good friend of mine and a sculptor, painter, artist, was nice enough to do a repaint on the head and hands for me. And I just was very grateful. It's turned out really, really well. I found this log, had to debug it because it had bugs and stuff in it for quite a while. And I built the base for it. So this kind of gives you an idea of the landscape that Luke, R2, and Yoda are gonna have at the Dark Side. I love this one. This is just something about Yoda and Dagobah, hands down my favorite environment in Star Wars. It's really, really comfortable. This is just a Disney light. It's not gonna be with this display, I don't think. Down here in the mess of things is, you guys might recognize this, a good friend of mine, Ryan, donated this to the collection, and this is gonna be at Dark Side. He sent it initially white. A lot of you guys might see people running in the original Empire Strikes Back down the hallway in Bespin, and it's been kind of, it's an iconic piece. It's been used in Mandalorian, I believe, but a lot of people don't realize that this same piece was used. And it's an ice cream machine. And this thing was actually used in Empire Strikes Back on Dagobah, not just on Bespin. But it's an environmental background piece, I guess, that Luke had to take off the X-Wing and use it for something. But when he's upside down, lifting the rocks and Yoda up, this piece can be seen in the background. People didn't know that. I didn't know it till my friend Ryan let me know about it. And of course, here we go. So a lot of you guys know my love for the original Star Wars classic action figures, the Kenner side of things. And of course, I love the mini rigs like a lot of you guys. When Gentle Giant came out with the 12-inch jumbos, it was exciting. It was like, oh, that's cool. We can get a bigger figure. And little did we know that They'd go to life size, but that's okay. That's another story. But I was real happy to know about the jumbo figures. The problem is you got to have vehicles with these 12-inch jumbo figures. Well, Izzy Mel, a good friend of mine, wasn't as easy as you would think that it would be. He didn't just scan it. He drew the toy. So I would send this toy to him, and he would redraw this, and then he would print it out and recreate this thing in a 6-scale version. So this is working, it articulates. I don't have the rubber band hooked up to this thing, but it does stand up like this, and it also will sit down, obviously, as it's sitting right now. Up here, we've got the medical droid in here, and you can see by scale the details. It took about a year to create these three mini rig vehicles. This thing pops open. Getting a clear dome matched was not easy, but Izzy pulled it off, and I'm really proud of him. It's a badass. So my plan is to display these very similar to how they were displayed on the snow and like on the Kenner box. Here's another one of the mini rig collections. When I say collections, that I'm collecting, and Izzy's doing one at a time as we go. And he's got another one that he's working on now, but look at this, look at the details. I mean, fantastic work. I, of course, painted it, and he did the decals for me. But this is a 12-inch figure. I mean, it's very, very accurate to a 12-inch versus the Kenner 3 and 3.5 inch. I've showed you guys before the Gentle Giant Monument R2-D2, which was my first action figure. My favorite all-time figure is the cloth, not the vinyl cape, but the cloth Jawa. But I was able to pick this one up off of Etsy, and I can't remember the guy's name, but did a fantastic job on this piece. It is very solid. If I can remember, it was around $3,000. It wasn't cheap, but I love this. I love this piece. A lot of you guys might recognize this vintage toy. Well, this was inspiration to create what would have been on screen. You know, as kids, you know, we were playing with these toys and just, you know, using our imaginations. Well, Jason Eaton, he's still a kid at heart, and he's taken, you know, his childhood fantasies and gotten crazy and made the real deal. So I love when he does stuff like this. So I've got a friend of mine, Izzy, that we just mentioned, that makes all the remakes of like the Kenner, the toys. Well, what I've got, you know, Jason, he's been playing with these. He builds these stuff that were a toy, but could have been absolutely used in the film. And that's what's so cool about this. Guys, look at this. You can absolutely see this roaring through Endor, through the forest, and stopping and shooting, picking off a couple Ewoks out of the trees. No, I'm just kidding, but it would have been, you know, really, really cool to see these guys. This is, as you can see, a 6-scale piece. You can see a custom that I have here that I got from Joel. And this actually has, if you look down around over here, this is actual cool shade, like they used in the TIE Fighters in A New Hope. And then the details behind the cool shade. And if you can look at the details in the back, the thrusters. I mean, this is a video that should be shot on its own. I just love this piece so much. I was excited to show you guys. And then it's got like headlights on the front. So as it scoops through the forest at nighttime, I mean, damn. This will be displayed in the studio scale room. Looking forward to showing you guys its final display. Great inspiration. Toy as a kid, loved playing with this thing. And Jason Eaton, great job on this piece. Love it. Much like the toy, how this thing completely rotates around. Well, this one here does the exact same thing. I'm not gonna go all the way around because I got the guy underneath here, but yeah, this thing is, you can put it in any position and just look at it. It's just incredibly cool. One of my favorite pieces in the collection. So a lot of you guys know my love for 6-scale. I'm kind of a when, you know, I always say, oh, I'm not gonna get into, I'm getting out of six scale, I've got too much of it. All of a sudden something else comes out and I got to just have that one thing. And then just before you know it, you've got 30 new pieces yet. You guys know what I'm talking about. Anyways, so you guys remember this Chewy right here that Hot Toys came out with. And if you could take a close up, those of you that have this Chewy, now he's a beautiful piece. It was really exciting. Sold out pretty quick. But if you guys look at his head sculpt, to me, that is not Chewbacca. That is a Wookiee for sure, but it's not Chewy. Well, a friend of mine, based out of Hawaii, fantastic dude, incredible sculptor, created this custom six scale Chewy. If you guys can look at this detail, I'll put his name down on the bottom so you guys can see who he is. Fantastic artist. He just created one that he's doing the Roar, which is really cool, kind of like my life size Chewy that I have. But the head expressions are just amazing. I mean, with the right background, you would think that this is like, it could be a scene right out of the film. Yeah, you guys, if you can just see on that, this is just incredible details. This one right here is going to be on display at the Dark Side in the Jabba the Hutt diorama, created by Jens over at Legacy Arts. So he's going to be facing his doom with, or thinks he's facing doom against the mighty Jabba the Hutt. But God, just my favorite six scale action figure next to the Ewok low gray that Joel did for me. I just love these two pieces. These customs, these guys are just getting out of hand. I mean, when they are creating a 12 inch figure that looks like it's just spot on right out of the film where you can't tell. Then you take one of these like this and put it together. It's like, come on, Hot Toys, you need to get with it. Fantastic. So this is a Found Parts Fibro-X built by my lovely, cool-ass friend Ryan and his lovely wife Jules. This thing is all, of course, handmade, but very accurate to the ones that were done in the film. I'm not as knowledgeable as these guys when it comes to the accuracy and everything that was used, but it's really cool, some of the pieces. And if you guys stay tuned, my buddy Gabe at Star Wars Replicas is going to do a really nice review on this Fibro-X. So looking forward to displaying this in the Dark Side Brick Oven Pizza Company. He's going to be grasping it weekly. We're working on this guy right now, which is going to be really fun. But the details of everything that went into each and every piece, you know, whether it was a pistol, a lightsaber, or the axe. This thing is made out of aluminum right here. This will cut your freaking head off. I mean, this thing's got some weight to it. I mean, and this is all handcrafted by Ryan. He just did a fantastic job. Just the little details of the screws, the Kenner gun that was used, the hair dryer. It's crazy what went into this one little teeny prop in a big giant movie, you know? So looking forward to having this thing displayed the way it needs to be displayed. Great job, Ryan. You did a good job, buddy. Get to that article. So listen, I just wanted to say to you guys, thanks so much for taking the time to watch these silly videos that I put together. And again, thanks so much for your loyalty, because it's been over a year and, you know, we're still continuing to climb on subscribers, which is, it's just really cool. It just lets me know once again that you guys love the content on this channel, and we're going to do the best we can to keep it coming your way. So again, if you haven't already, please like and subscribe. Tell people about us, and don't forget about the Dark Side Brick Oven Pizza Company, because it's coming soon and we expect to see you there. Stay tuned to the next video. We'll see you.
It's okay, E.T. You're home now. Come on. Wait till you taste the pizza.
Good.